Brakate Yehovah, Brakate Oshe, Brakate Yehovah, Brakate Oshe, Brakate Yehovah, Brakate Oshe. All praises and glory to Yahweh Hashem Yehoshe, the blessed apostles and elders of great Milton and rule well. And salutations to the brothers outside, pushing the word and all truth and sincerity day in and day out, constantly. Right? And let's jump into the scriptures one time. There's Romans 12, verse 11. It says, not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. So, really and truly, when you look up the word fervent, right? It says, to be hot. Right? To be hot. Now, really and truly, we're supposed to be hot. We're spirit supposed to be hot, serving the Most High, Abba Hashem Yehoshai. Right? Because if your spirit could be hot to do anything outside in the world, meaning that, hey, your spirit could be hot to go and work, right? Your spirit could be hot to go and do some activity in the world, right? Why your spirit can be hot to serve the Messiah of Hashem Yehoshai? Hey, at the end of the day, basically, if you had a shoot, you can't be slothful, right? You can't be slothful. You really and truly have to be fervent. You have to be fervent. You have to keep on learning, because this truth is an ever learning thing. You don't stop learning this truth, right? Because it's constantly brothers bringing out knowledge, bringing out new classes, bringing out new stuff. So you know what? Your spirit always getting fed. Because man only live by bread alone, right? So we gotta feed the spirit too, and how we feed the spirit is by constantly being in this truth, being fervent, serving the Lord, serving the Abba Hashem Yehoshai. So let's read over that. It said, not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. And hey, that's the thing, men you really can't get slothful with this thing, really and truly. Because the scripture says the Most High will spew you out if you're lukewarm, and when you get slothful, you actually get lukewarm. You understand? Anything become anything. Right. So it's not a treaty Most High would, like if it's nothing. Right. You become slothful, you become laid back, you become comfortable. But really and truly, you're supposed to be fervent in the spirit, serving the Most High, Abba Hashem Yehoshai. Right? Again, ferventness means hot, so you know what? Your spirit always ready, it always hot, it heated. Right? Cap it slot for one. That's the thing, outside there, really and truly, you really can't be fervent to serve you, so, right? But you're not fervent to serve the Most High. Because you know, being fervent for the Most High is what we're going on to save you, right? It's all going on to save you. But you know what? Men rather be slothful. Just because you know the truth doesn't mean that is just it. And there's no feeling you know is an Israelite, that is just it. Because you know what? The Most High will take that knowledge from you. Because you say the little you have, you can take back. Right? That's roughly paraphrasing, but hey. Let's show you you have to be spiritual at all things. Right? So this Proverbs chapter 15 verse 9, it says, the way of the slothful man is an hedge of thorns, but the way of the righteous is made plain. So hey, you really can't be slothful, because you know what? That path you're taking is actually a hedge of, that road you're taking is really a dead end road. Really and truly. You can't be slothful. You really can't be thoughtful in this thing. again, just because you know the, you know, piece of the truth, right, that doesn't mean that it's just it. It'll constantly be serving the Most High Yahweh Hashem Yahusha, as Romans say, as the scripture in Romans say, it'll keep on being fervent in the spirit, right? So yeah, so hey, really can't be slothful. Now let's jump to the next scripture here, right? There's Hebrews chapter 6 verse 10 going down, right? It says, "For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, for which ye have showed toward his name, and that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister." So yes, so the Most High won't forget your work. You constantly doing this work to actually receive a reward, right? And hopefully it is of the elect, right? Because we hope we have the elect. Right, hopefully of the elect to receive that glory, that kingdom, you understand, that crown of life, right? So Hebrews 6 verse 10, "For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which you have showed toward his name," right? Because you know what, again, what's how important it is, you have to be fervent in the spirit to always be preaching in the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahusha, right? It says, "Which ye have showed toward his name, in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister." So we continually be ministering, right? As Apostle Ta say, you know, but two videos need to be done a week, right? Is to always keep the brothers fervent, because these men see it spiritually, these men don't see it carnally, right? When you're doing these videos, you're actually doing the, you're doing the work, plus you're keeping your spirit intact in order, right? It's verse 11. It says, "And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope unto the end." So really and truly, hey, if you're not slothful and you're fervent, right, you're showing that diligence, right? And that diligence, as the scripture says, to the full assurance of hope unto the end, because again, you know what we're hoping for. So if you're hoping for something, wouldn't you show all diligence to that particular thing? Because if you had to buy a car, you'll be diligent to go and work, right? You'll be diligent to go and work to assure you go and get that car, right? But if you want the glory and the kingdom, you have to be diligent as well. You have to be diligent as well to receive that, right? So Hebrews 6:11, "And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence." Because any idea, if all the rest are men, right, being diligent, you yourself had to be diligent as well. You understand? It didn't say some, right? That every one of you, right, do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope unto the end. Right? Again, if you're fervent in spirit, right, you'll show all diligence, because you know you're hoping for something, but you have to be showing all diligence. It says verse 12, right, it says that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. So that's the thing, again, like slothful pop up. Scripture say that ye be not slothful, and that is the thing, is this slot, don't make that slothful spirit hit you, because you'll feel at rest, you'll get lukewarm. It say that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. And that is the thing, with patience, through faith and patience, we inherit them promises. be fervent in the spirit. When you're fervent in the spirit, you're hot in the spirit, right? And in a slothful, hey, your patience does build and your faith do build, right? Because you're hot, you're always in your spirit. As a matter of fact, you're always in your spirit, right? You say that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. And that is the thing, hey, don't be slothful, because you know, if you're slothful, you're not going to inherit that them promises. You're not going to inherit it. Because you really feel the most, like, well, any slothful man in the kingdom. It's the same way in these work outside here. They don't want a lazy person working for them, because there are work to be done. So why would they hire a lazy person? Right? It's the same way with the Mosai kingdom and the Mosai army. You really feel when anybody is slothful? Come on now, man, let's be real with it. Right? So with that, it's just basically to touch on being fervent. Don't be slothful. Right, be fervent, always be heated, always have that hotness in your spirit to do the most high work. Right? Because if you could go and do something else in the world, you could take that same time and do it for Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Right? Same way. So with that, I'm going to give out praises and glory and honor to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, the balance of the apostles and elders of great Nelson, that teach us the truth. And keep on teaching us this truth. Keep teaching us this truth. Okay, you know, these men fervent in the spirit since I get woken up. Right? And even before that, because I hear men be saying it. Right? And shalom to the hopefully like outside there. So until then, you say shalom again.